Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the expressions of single phase half wave controlled rectifier with RL load. Okay, so these waveforms we already discussed in the last video. Okay, so let us derive the expressions. So first, V0 average value of output voltage. Okay, so if you check the V0 average or the V0 waveform, from omega t is equal to 0 to 2 pi, whatever the pulse we are having, the same waveform is repeating from 2 pi to 4 pi and 4 pi to 6 pi and so on. Okay, so the periodic angle is 2 pi. So it is a 1 by 2 pi, right? Integration from 0 to 2 pi. But in between 0 to 2 pi, we are having the effective interval is from alpha to beta. Okay, so it is integration from alpha to beta. During alpha to beta, what is the V0? Yes, it is a Vm into sine of omega t into d omega t, right? Now, can we simplify it? Yes, it is equal to Vm by 2 pi into, yes, integration of sine, it is a minus cos of omega t limit alpha to beta, right? So, this can be written as Vm by 2 pi into, yes, minus cos beta plus cos alpha. So it is a cos alpha minus cos beta, right? This is a V0 average value of output voltage. Next, what is the I0 average? I0 average is equal to V0 average by R. V0 average by R, right? We know the average voltage across the inductor is 0. Okay, so average load voltage is equal to average voltage across the resistor only. Okay, what is the average voltage across the resistor? I0 average into R, right? So I0 average is equal to V0 average by R. Next, let us derive the expression for V0 RMS. Okay, so I am writing here V0 RMS is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from alpha to beta. Yes, Vm square into sine square of omega t into d omega t to the power 1 by 2, right? So this is V0 RMS. Now further, can we simplify it? Yes, we can take Vm square by 2 pi outside. So V0 RMS is equal to Vm upon root 2 pi, okay, into, yes, it is sine square of omega t. So integration from alpha to beta, what is this sine square of omega t? This can be written as 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2 into d omega t to the power 1 by 2. Okay, so further we can simplify it as Vm by root 2 pi. Can we take this divided by 2 outside? So it is root 2 into root 2. So it is a 2 root pi. Okay, into it, this will be omega t minus integration of cos is sine of 2 omega t divided by 2 limit alpha to beta. Okay, to the power 1 by 2. Right, so further can we simplify it as, yes, Vm upon 2 root pi into, yes, it is beta minus alpha, right, minus sine of 2 beta by 2 plus sine of 2 alpha by 2. Okay, so it is a plus sine of 2 alpha by 2 minus sine of 2 beta by 2. Sine of 2 beta by 2. Okay, so here we can write V0 RMS. This is the expression for V0 RMS. RMS value of output voltage. Okay. Next, can we write I0 RMS? Yes, I0 RMS approximate value is equal to V0 RMS by R. V0 RMS by R. Okay. If we want to find the exact value, then we need to find the expression of this waveform first. And after that, we need to find the RMS of that waveform. Okay. So it will be a very big expression. Okay. So in the half uncontrolled rectifier also, we have discussed this point. Okay. Next. So this is the I0 RMS. Next, what is the load power? P0 average is equal to V0 RMS into I0 RMS. Right. V0 RMS into I0 RMS. Because in the load, yes, we are having the resistor and inductor. What is the power consumed by the inductor? It will be 0. Real power consumed by the inductor is 0. Okay. So only resistor is consuming the power. Okay. So P0 average is V0 RMS into I0 RMS. Okay. Is this clear? Next. So this is the load power. Next, can we find the conduction time of thyristor? conduction time of thyristor. We can write it as conduction time of thyristor T. Yes, is equal to, if you check the VT waveform, thyristor T will be in the on state only from alpha to beta. So conduction angle is beta minus alpha. Conduction time is beta minus alpha divided by omega, right? This is the conduction time of thyristor. Okay, next, can we write the PIV rating of thyristor? Yes, if you check the VT waveform, you will get an idea. What is the PIV rating of thyristor? Yes, PIV rating of thyristor. Yes, VT, we are having this waveform. Okay, so what is the peak voltage? It is a VM. Okay, so V max, it is the PIV, peak inverse voltage across the thyristor. Okay, next, circuit turn off time, TC for thyristor. TC stands for circuit turn off time. Okay, so TC for thyristor T. If you check, yes, the current flowing through thyristor T, as we have already discussed, I0, IS, and IT all are same. Okay. At omega t is equal to beta, current flowing through thyristor T becomes 0. And after that, the reverse voltage is maintained till 2 pi. Okay, so it is a 2 pi minus beta. It is a 2 pi minus beta divided by omega. This is a circuit turn-off time for thyristor T. Are you getting the point? Okay, so this is about the expressions of RL load. Okay, in the next video, we are going to discuss the single phase half wave controlled rectifier with RL load and with the freewheeling diode. Thank you.